So labor is a really stressful process for the baby and his head and his body, especially after a really long labor or a really short one, or like with the use of tools like ventouse, forceps. And if the baby doesn't recover properly from all this stress, can lead to various conditions and symptoms like misshapen head, difficult like sleeping, irritability, feeding difficulties, colic, that sort of thing, or ear and eyes issues. And usually osteopathy is really helpful with those conditions.
So, I mean, because this happened to me, I just wanted to say, what would you actually do? If I'm a mum, I've got this baby, had a difficult birth and is not sleeping and maybe having difficulty feeding, and I come to you, what kind of process would happen?
So I'll do obviously a case history to know in details about the birth and like his habits, like sleeping habits, feeding habits, everything I can know about the baby.
Mm.
Then I'll do an osteopathic examination. Mm. And with babies, we use mainly cranial osteopathy, which is the most gentle approach, basically.
Right.
And it will be mainly putting my hands on his head to assess all the stress in there, any strains or tension, especially.
And you are trained so you can feel all sorts of.
Yeah, we've got 4 years training to be able to feel that.
Mm.
And we've got an undergraduate experience where we've treated a lot of babies already.
So you're a baby expert osteopath. not every osteopath can do babies.
Not everybody likes treating babies too, so it's true. It's sort of a specialty in osteopathy, and basically we assess the movement of each bone in the head, basically in the skull, and if there's any restriction there, any tension, we sort of release those tension, and sometimes those tension and strains can compress some nerves that go from the base of the skull to the body, basically. And that can give digestive problems or sleep disturbances.
And presumably these might last the rest of your life if you don't get them sorted out. So this is
some babies really need treatment as early as possible to avoid these problems to last all the life, basically.
Yeah.
Especially with the shape of the head, things like that. If we don't address that as soon as possible, it's going to stay, basically.
Just got a question. What about parents of children who are a bit older? Is it still worth maybe?
Of course, specifically with the shape of the head, it's better to bring the child before 1 year old, because when the sort of skull starts to fuse.
Yeah.
But children after a year old can still benefit from the treatment because they're growing, they're going to a lot of different experience, and they learn a lot in that time. So it's really for any.
So if you didn't happen to know about it at the right moment, you can still catch up a bit.
There's, and we use cranial osteopathy on anyone. The age doesn't matter, basically. It can be on elderly person, on adults. It's really for everybody. But it's the sort of approach of choice on babies. Because obviously we can do more sort of forceful techniques that we might do on adults, like manipulations, things like that. Because they're so like delicate and fragile, it's the main technique we use on them.
Because their heads are going to be distorted often.
Like a really light touch. They won't feel anything, basically. But we do feel a lot because we train our hands, are trained to feel all that, basically. So for the baby, it's a really really gentle treatment. Some babies just fall asleep during treatment.
Yes.
But with some babies with quite a lot of stress, it might be just a bit uncomfortable, so they might cry a bit.
Mm.
But it's like a really pain-free treatment completely for the baby.
Yeah. Because they're just sort of letting it go, and that kind of can.
Yeah, it's just when we find the core of the problem, that's when it's a bit uncomfortable for them, mm. possibly. And then once we release all that, they just feel like a relief and they sort of sigh and mm. like go to sleep.
Oh.
And,
yeah, that must be very satisfying.
Yeah, it's really, really nice to see them finally yeah. letting go. And
like this, yeah. their arms up again. Yeah.
Exactly, yeah. Mm. Oh, yeah. And we also treat children, usually if we start to see a child as a baby, we sort of follow them along like their growth and their life, basically,
right.
because the sort of growth process can be also a bit stressful, especially in children that grow really quickly with a big growth spurt and
yeah.
things like that. And with children that got like braces, or that are very active,
mm.
We need just to monitor.
Braces, yeah, you
yeah,
mean under the teeth?
Yeah,
yeah, and I've heard of this, because obviously that's putting stress on
yeah,
your skull.
It's like a lot of tension
yeah.
in the jaw, and obviously the jaw is connected to the skull,
mm.
to the neck, and then if the neck is sort of misaligned, it's going to have an effect on the whole spine, on the posture, things like that.
Does cranial osteopathy help people, just wondering, with vision? Problems
yeah,
because I know that
because the orbit is made
yeah.
of yeah different bones and there's muscles, membranes. So yeah, we can sort of help any tension, like
mm.
especially if you've got some eye strains like
mm.
that. Where we just release all the,
mm.
the tension we can find there. Yeah.
Fantastic. Mm. Yeah.
So yeah, it's
yeah.
like for babies, children, any age.
What about yeah, after birth mums? That are they,
yeah,
you know, do they? I mean, I suppose they're with their babies, so do they get
yeah,
treated?
Yeah, we can sort of
yeah.
do the baby, then the mother,
mm.
or the opposite. But it's really good. Usually, if mother can come during the pregnancy and after. Because
mm.
during the pregnancy, they're going through a lot of changes, like
mm.
postural changes,
mm.
hormonal changes, that are going to put a lot of stress on their body, especially
mm.
pelvis, the low back,
right.
and they can have like yeah pelvic pain, low back pain, trapped nerves,
mm.
things like that. So usually mother are really grateful that we follow them during the pregnancy because we can relieve any sort of tension that comes in. And once they went through the labor, the pelvis obviously went through a sort of quite tremendous stresses.
Sure, yeah, yeah.
And it's just, us checking if everything went back into place, basically, and that there's no sort of misalignment or tissue that went into too much stress, basically.
Because mm, I'm just thinking it's a bit like the baby's skull is moving and the woman's pelvis is also
yeah,
designed to adapt.
To
yeah.
the baby
so they both need to sort of settle back right, otherwise
yeah,
there could
exactly,
be.
Yeah.
yeah.
And especially after birth, mother sort of focused a lot on their babies
yeah.
and not so much on them, you know.
Right.
And
yes.
sometimes it's good for them to just come and think about
mm.
Themselves, their body,
mm.
and sort of. And when they feel better, it's better for the baby too. So it's
yes.
like a two-way thing. They take care so much. And the baby, you know,
yeah.
and sometimes it's just good for them to feel a bit better, a bit less achy, and make sure everything is all right. So yeah, quite often we treat baby and mother to sort of together on some days, but it's yeah, it's really important for them to think about their body too.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely.
Not only the baby, yeah. Mm.
And yeah, so I was just wanted to ask you about the free osteopathic spinal check. Is
yeah.
that
that's something,
appropriate to talk about now, or is that? Yeah.
yeah. So it's a free osteopathic assessment. So people that sort of wonder if osteopathy can help them, if they should come,
mm.
If they've got any questions, they can come. It's usually 10-15 minutes. They can ask any question, and I'm just doing a sort of. Assessment of the spine or any area of the body where they feel the pain,
mm.
basically,
and
let them know what sort of work I have to do, if they need or not treatment, and then it's up to them to book a proper appointment. So it's just completely free and just sort of giving information for them to think about.
Well, that's really good. So yeah, in 15 minutes you can you know, get a good idea if you look at their back.
I'm just doing a few tests, basically, seeing what the spine is moving or how, let's say, the neck is moving or if they've got a foot pain or how the foot is.
Really? So it's the whole body, it's not just the spine.
Yeah, it can be, any part of the body, basically. And then they'll know, what needs to be done or not, and if they want to, open up a room with me, basically.
Brilliant. So that's a cool anesthetic job.
Yeah. And it's on Mondays morning and Friday afternoons.
Brilliant. Very much. Did you want to say anything other?
About that, osteopathy is not only for babies, children, and pregnant women. It can be for anyone.
But you're a specialist with babies.
So I have a special interest in babies, mothers, and
Brilliant. Thank you, Charles. Switch it off.
Yeah.